So when our son was born, he had a thumb abnormality. Oftentimes when kids have issues with their thumb when they're born, it's associated with other things. So that was one of the main reasons why we had him see a geneticist. He was diagnosed with Fanconi Anemia when he was about 2 months old. Fanconi Anemia is a rare genetic blood disorder, and it leads to cancer, usually of the head and neck, but also leukemia at an early age. There's 16 known types of Fanconi Anemia. Niko's happens to be one of the rarest and most severe. So kids with Fanconi Anemia can live to about 30, 40. They tend to go into bone marrow failure, and a lot of them do get bone marrow transplants. And later on, they're at risk for cancers of the head and neck. But Niko is at risk around this age, around two, for having tumors in the brain and also leukemia.
Foundation is Gary Cogswell Remember the Children Foundation. It was done after my father, Gary Cogswell, who passed away from a double lung transplant. The things that our family went through, we wanted to make sure that we were a voice to be able to help other people as well. The main things are the medications. Medications can be, after insurance, $2,000. And sometimes they reject those medications. And when that happens, the Costco can be $4,000 that week. And these medications are what keeps people alive, the patients, the younger ones, the adults. So it was very important that we stand for that. I believe everyone wants to help. You just have to direct them and give them something to do. And then, they'll stand for whatever cause. It doesn't matter what your cause is, as long as you're giving. I met Joanna and Mike. My husband's also a fireman. So it's the brotherhood that happens. And they came to me, and my husband said, "Julie, you have to meet this family." And I said, "Well, wait a minute. This is what we need to do."
You're reading up, getting more information on FA. Learning Niko and how different he is from Michaela, and over that year we went and saw doctors initially in Minnesota. She went to Maryland with kids. We went to Maine to see more specialists through symposiums.
I believe a lot of times when people are going through illnesses, they don't have that voice because they're so worried about doing the day-to-day things just to keep it together for their children or their significant other, that people need that voice.
The reason why I wanted to do it, because I wanted to help in any type of way I can to help raise money to help take care of his situation that this kid is going through. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, you want to do things like that because that goes a long way. I don't know if my kid's gonna have any type of illness where I'm not around to help him. And hopefully there's somebody out there that would be willing to help out, you know what I'm saying? So that was definitely one of the main things I wanted to do, to make sure I do what I can do, because at the end of the day, they need help. And there's plenty of kids out there that needs help too. So. And I always push forward for helping young kids out. So that's one of the main things I wanted to do. And having the time just to meet Niko and his family is just a great honor. I wear the bracelet all the time. Like I said, sometimes I use different motivation to get my mind right for different days of practice and stuff. And some days I look down at this bracelet, I was like, okay, this is for Niko. Even though I haven't met him, but I know he's going through something today. You know what I'm saying? He had something that Niko is going through today. And this day of football practice dedicated to Niko. I'm gonna play my butt off for Niko. We're gonna do whatever we can to help him. And I'm just honored, you know what I'm saying, and blessed to be around this family.
People don't understand with transplants or that just is affected, they cannot be around a large amount of people. I've been working and doing things, and I know others, to try to get just 2 hours before the park opens so that they can have that memory as a family, because all children, they want to go to Disneyland or Disney World. So I believe that'll happen, and I hope everyone who hears this story will reach out and help the Peros family. And it's been a great experience as far as just other people seeing what they're willing to do for another person. So you can go to rtcfoundation.com, and you can donate. Their story is there. All those dollars that come go directly to the actual individual families. And Joanna really wants to make sure, and one of her big things that she stated was to do the research to find out why this disease is what it does and how they can help.
Don't worry about a thing. This morning.